Hi everyone, in this video we are going to learn what is pip, how you can install pip in your system, how you can install packages using pip, how you can upgrade them, how you can uninstall them, and what are the alternatives of pip. All of this I'm going to talk in this video. And if you are someone who wants to learn about data science, engineering and computer science, then in this channel we upload videos related to this. So please consider subscribing and coming up. Alright, so we're going to talk about pip in this video. Now if you are someone who has been working on Python or maybe in data science, you have been using pip in your day-to-day life. So actually the full form of pip is pip install packages. Yes, the actual P stands for pip itself and the full form is pip install packages. And it is used to install Python packages. Now what are these Python packages? Now these Python packages are actually open source softwares that are developed by the community and you get it for free. For instance, Django is a package, right? Django is a framework that you can use to build websites using Python. Now to go ahead and install Django, you just write pip install Django. So it's open source, it's free, and if you want to go ahead and download it and use it in your system, you use the pip command. No doubt, as I say, this is open source, so all the open source codes are also available on GitHub and you can just download it and start using it. But it's an easy way to install packages in your Python project. Now if you come from a JavaScript background or if you have heard something called npm, that is node package manager, it is very similar to pip. It's just pip is used for the Python ecosystem. Now, is pip cross-platform? Yes, pip works on macOS, Linux, and also on Windows. Now, how do you actually go ahead and install pip? That is the second part of this video. Now, if you are someone who's working on Python version 2.7.9 or greater, and Python 3.4 and greater, pip actually comes installed. Now, if you just go ahead and install any version of Python that is above than this, you will get pip in your system by default. And I have made a dedicated video on how you can go ahead and install Python in your system and configure it. I'll give a link in the description and also up over here so that you can follow along. Apart from that, if you want to go ahead and create a virtual environment, which many Python developers and data science guys like to do it, virtual environment is a separate entity where you install packages dedicated to a particular project. Now if you also want to go ahead and do that, pip is also available over there and you can actually create a virtual environment using pip command. Now just like packages, you also need to go ahead and upgrade your pip. For instance, Django has different versions of packages, NumPy has different versions, even pip has its own version. So if you want to go ahead and upgrade your pip, what you do is you go to your command prompt and write py-m pip install -u space pip. This will upgrade your pip into the latest version of pip. Now let's get to the important part, that is using pip to install packages. And this is something that you're going to do it most of the time. As I did take the example of Django, NumPy, SciPy, Matplot, and many, many other libraries out there, you can go ahead and use pip to install them. And the way you do it is you go to your terminal and type pip space install, then the package name. Now, when you do this, you are actually installing the latest version of that package. Now, for instance, Django comes in 4 version and you want to install the version number 3. The way you do it is you again go back to your terminal and write pip install package name, then double equals to, then the version of that package. In this way, you install a particular version of that package. Now, for instance, you want to install a package that is greater than 3. For instance, you're again installing a Django package and you want that, hey, you want all the versions that is greater than 2. So what you do is you go to your terminal and this time you are going to write pip install package name, then greater than or equal to, then the version number, and all this within single quotes. Now this will install the minimum version of package in your system. Now, once you have installed your package, there are chances that you also want to go ahead and uninstall them. And the way you do it is you write pip space uninstall, then the package name. Now, it is pretty interesting that when you go ahead and upgrade a package, right, the older version of package is deleted and then the new version of package is installed. For instance, I'll again take the example of Django. If you're installing Python Django version 4, I'm just giving an example. I don't know what's the exact version of Django is. Now, if you're installing the Python version Django 4 and if you already had Python version Django 3 installed, it will uninstall Django 3 and then install Django 4. Don't worry, your application will still be up and running without any issues. Now, the final thing that I have for you, and this is kind of bonus, is the alternate of pips. Now, I have not actually used this many times, but I have definitely seen developers using it. The first alternate that we have is the pip tools, and the second alternate that we have is the poetry. No doubt, you may also need pip to go ahead and actually install them, but these are also some of the open library packages that contributors would like to go ahead and contribute, and pretty handy. Definitely go and check it out. I'll give their link in the description. So that was all in this video from my side. Please don't forget to like, share and subscribe, and drop your questions in the comments or any topic that you want me to cover in the following videos. As you can see, these days I upload videos related to more Python, data science and machine learning. So feel free to go ahead and drop your comments in the comment section, and I'll make sure that I'll reply them as soon as possible. So thank you so much. My name is Stephen Simon, and I'll catch you in the next episode.